Okay, I'll do a little video here. Talk about this Swedish brush clearing axe. I guess is the most common name for them. There's a few videos on YouTube, but there's not like a whole lot of, I don't know, reviews or people show what they're, have different dimensions and so forth, and so people maybe could decide if they was something they would want to buy or something that'd be useful for them. I first saw these like it was like years and years and years ago at a hardware store, and I kind of thought that was kind of neat, but at the time I think it was like $40 or something, and I kind of thought it was kind of expensive, but then I wasn't really sure what they were actually called, so it was kind of hard to track down where to find them or what they were or this kind of stuff. So I forget how I saw them on YouTube somehow or something or other. Saw they were Swedish clearing axes or just clearing axes, or I guess some people call them like just a Sandvik or something, which I guess is the old name for Bahco or whatever. But so anyway, I tracked them down and they were selling them at Home Hardware. So I ordered one in and they were they're like $59 now, which I suppose isn't really bad. Like, it is made in Sweden, this one. There's a nice hickory handle on it. You can see the grain is really good on this one. So hickory handle. This part of here where the handle goes in, there's a bolt through it. And this also protects it from when you're bashing your way through brush and stuff, because you're hitting stuff with the blade, but you're also hitting here. And this is spring steel, this part, and then the blade is it's held from the springiness of this. The way to replace the blades, you pinch like this part in a vise, and then pull up on the blade, and it sort of or pull up on the handle, I mean, to squeeze it together, and then you can get the blade out. There's a little round pin on this side. And one on this side, there's a little notch it sits in. And then there's grooves the blade goes into. You can buy replacement blades. So the thing's like $59, the whole thing. The handles, I think, are like $20 or something for the hickory handle, and the blades are 15 or something. And they're like a carbon steel. Well, I've been hacking around a little bit with it, and the blade doesn't show any damage, so it's just a one-sided blade on this one, but you can, I guess the Bahco one, I guess, but you can also get, I think Witherlings or something makes a version of this. There's a short one and a longer one, and some of them have the blades are sharpened on both sides, so you just turn them around when they get dull, but it comes with a little guard here to put on. I think some have a, there's a thing you can get, a sheath you can get for them. They're like a really good, handy little, like, thing for chopping brush. They're a lot safer than, like, a machete. I think that's one of the main kind of things that they, is for, like, when they're selling them, one of the kind of things, points they use quite a bit for, like, a selling point. But they're a lot safer because you have two hands on it. And they're still fairly light, though. The whole thing together is only about 2 pounds. So it's about a kilogram. As I said, the handle's about just 20 inches to here. About 26 and a half up to here, I guess. The blade, the cutting surface is about 5.5 inches. I think the blades are about 7 inches all the way, all the length, the full length of the blade, but it's got 5.5 inches of part that cuts. So, but yeah, so they're really useful. I think like the a lot of people use them, like people that maintain like trails in the woods, or people that cut like cut lines, like surveyors. People that work for like the power corporations that cut around the high voltage lines that go through the woods and stuff. For clearing that kind of stuff, things that you don't need a chainsaw for, like they're you can cut up to, I think it says 2 inches, yeah, because there's 2 inches of space behind the blade, so you can sort of cut through, I guess you can cut through a bit more than that, but it's, theoretically they're meant for something that's 2 inches or less, but they're mostly for, I don't know, thinner stuff, like that, but they work quite well. A lot of people that have like ATVs carry them sometimes for, there's all kinds of, you know, stuff blows down across the trail, and I don't know, if you're camping, clearing like a camping space, or you know, like having a problem with, like, you know, your tree stand kind of thing, if you clear some stuff around, you know, where it's applicable. I think you're, most places kind of frown on you just randomly going out in the woods and just hacking down everything, but anyway, so this is EIA, I guess is the, that's inside of a Q, but I'm not really sure if that's the maker or what, but it says 3022 is the, is like the Baco product number or something or other, I don't know, like if you, when you look it up, like Baco number 3022, it's this thing, so this is made in Sweden, 3022 as well, and it has like an acorn thing pressed into the middle there, but overall I'm really impressed with it. I'm never a big fan of machetes, they're kind of, I don't know, but something like this, so you can go a little bit more work with it, it seems like, but cut down both the same amount of stuff. It works good on, it's on a softwood, seems to work on the best, but it's, I think it's more technique too, because sometimes when there's sort of like real thin, like little trees that are kind of springy, you gotta kind of cut them a certain way, like on an angle or close to the ground so that they don't just whip around, and I guess that's the same with like machetes sometimes, but there'd probably be murder on like that Japanese knotweed stuff too, so, but anyway, I was almost thinking to order one of these handles for these, and put in like a, sort of like a smallish hatchet sort of head on it or something, because that'd be kind of a, probably kind of a useful little axe too, with a 20-inch handle, but that's just an idea, but can't see this thing, can't see busting the handle anytime soon, but because it's got good protection here with the steel, and it's a pretty sturdy looking handle, as long as you're careful and not bashing it on stuff. It's not like, it's not an axe for cutting down trees, it's for cutting little stuff, so a lot of the little things that would hit against this would have, you know, not going to bust the handle, so, but anyway, I figured I'd do a little video on that, show the dimensions of it, and I was sort of interested in it, but there's all kinds of places you can get these. Amazon has them, as I said, Home Hardware in Canada has them. And there were some other outdoorsy places I saw. But, anyway, thanks for watching. Talk to you later.